And now, no breaks. The next talk is coming right away. It is about QA misunderstood Demiurge. I misunderstood that.
Well, I didn't understand it either, so don't worry. I think we have someone who will going to explain it to all of us here, and that's our next speaker.
Teodora Nikolova is a test analyst at Innovative Lab, and she has more than 3 years of experience as manual QA engineer.
Teodora also has teaching background, so she will share with us her very different point of view about QA profession and in general.
Teodora debuts as a speaker from our stage, so please join me in supporting her with a big applause.
Let's welcome Teodora Nikolova!
I have some problems. I think, okay. Hi guys. My talk is about the role of the QA in the SDLC, and I will share with you some tips for improvement of your work productivity from a psychological point of view. But at first, a few words about me. I'm Teodora Nikolova, and I'm a philosopher by education. You know, I was a teacher and a school vice principal, by chance with more than eight years of experience. But now I'm a happy test analyst at Innovative Lab. I don't have a lot of hobbies, only two. Long distance running and table tennis, it's my passion. I'm also a certified ITTF table tennis coach. But let's start with the presentation. This is a short agenda, reasons behind this talk, the QA as a demiurge, really. And finally, some ideas for improvement of your work productivity. So, why did I decide to share my interpretation of the role of the QA in the software development process? Maybe the first question is, when did I decide to do it? It happened last year, at the last edition of the conference. Then I told my colleagues, if I have the chance, I will be one of the speakers at the next edition. And I'm here right now thanks to all of you who voted for me. Thanks a lot. I'm happy to be here and to share with you my lessons, my experience as a QA with only 3 years of experience. So the next question is why I'm here. It is because last year, at the lightning talk, during the lightning talks, some colleagues shared with us that they weren't feeling well. And I was very excited and surprised because they were young and smart and good specialists, but they were under stress and they shared with us their ways to deal with this stress. Then I thought about the possible reasons for their situation. Of course, the answer cannot be simple because the reasons can be different, but I think we can organize them in two categories, objective and subjective. So when the people explain their feelings, their attitude with external events, with events that are beyond their control, we can talk about objective reasons, and then these people have external locus of control. So their credo is, things happen to me. In our context, it means that the QA lead, the team members, the project manager, the product owner, etc., the complexity of the software are responsible for the mistakes of these QAs. And what do they do? They leave the company. But it is not the right solution for me because they will find the same situation again and again. So for me, the right solution is to change the locus of control from external to internal. What does it mean? It means that our feelings, our mistakes will be explained with internal factors. Such factors are our qualities, our efforts, of course, the knowledge and the experience we possess. In fact, I describe my own experience. I started working as a QA without any experience and with the knowledge from a single course. Of course, I still could be foundation level. Of course, I had to work with a lot of people, with a different mindset, with different temperaments and moral. And of course, I had a lot of bad days. I made a lot of mistakes. I had a lot of challenges in front of me. And instead of considering the other people and the circumstances responsible for my situation, I started improving my experience and my knowledge with additional courses, with a lot of extra hours in the application, and with additional communication with the team members, and the results came very fast. I want to say that when our experience and our knowledge are amplified each other, when we improve our skills, our soft skills also, of course, then we will be able to see more and more things. And we will be able to take steps to prevent the issues, the potential issues in the future. The next topic is the QA as a demiurge, this awful word demiurge, but I will explain it after a few minutes. In some sense, this topic is related to the quality assurance job descriptions. I'm sure you have seen a lot of job descriptions, but here you are an example. The best candidate has good knowledge and experience in different domains, and of course, he has to possess different skills from different kind. It seems that it is very hard to meet all these requirements, but from a philosophical point of view, they represent the real image of the QA for me, the image of the QA as a demiurge. That is, the etymology of the word refers to two other words, people and work. Today, demiurge is used as a synonym of God, of course. And fortunately, we aren't gods. We are only specialists, masters. And for me, the QA is the person responsible for the fashioning of the real world, of our world. I will illustrate my interpretation by using the Plato's allegory for the cave. You see on the top of the picture, it is the best word in the mind of the PO, but I want to turn your attention to the bottom of the picture, to the cave. It is our empirical word. So the only reality for the people that are in the cave is what they see. These are the users. On the other side, you see here, on the other side, there are other people who drive the things. They make things happen. These are the developers. And you see, there is a wall between them. It is because interactions between them don't exist. And here the role of the QA becomes very important, because he or she doesn't matter. He can see the product through the eyes of the users and through the eyes of the developers. And when the QA is able to see the big picture, when he understands it all, he passes to another higher level, because he can see discrepancies between expectations and reality, between requirements and delivery. So from a philosophical point of view, the QA as a demiurge is responsible for the materialization, of the product. And from an IT point of view, he contributes to the delivery to a working product with high quality. And finally, something related not to the philosophy, but to the psychology. The first subtopic is named the magical number 7. I will illustrate my idea with an example from my work. So the best ratio between developers and QA seems to be 2-to-1. In the most companies, it is 4-to-1. And it was my case until the team grew up. And now I have to work with 7 developers. And you can imagine what I feel, because there are 7 developers, and each developer works on 3 to 5 tickets per week, and I have to track 21-30 tickets in Jira, board. It is likely I released to miss something, and it would be crucial for my work, for the organization of my work in effective and efficient way. So I shared my confusion with my husband, who is a chess coach and a philosopher too, and he told me, Teodora, you don't have any problems. You have to read the article about the magical number 7. What are you talking about? I said in my mind, but I searched it in Google. You have imagined my surprise to understand that it is not about chess, it is about psychology. It is an article of George Miller, an American psychologist. He talks about about how our short-term memory works. For him, we can remember no more than 9 cognitive elements in our short-term memory. It is about 7 categories from different kind. It is the most important here. And when this number increases, we have to reorganize the categories in our memory so that this number is reduced, and then we won't any problems. And I did it. Instead of work with the categories of 7 developers in my mind, I started working with only 3 categories: stories, books, and tasks, because these items are important for me. This item will be tested, not the developers. And I think it is very interesting knowledge. You can apply it in your own context, in your daily life. And finally, some thoughts about our mutual work with the developers. It is not very original, but it is important for me, and I want to turn your attention to our communication with the developers. You agree it is very important, because the developers are the people that give us information about the application, how it works, or what the interactions between components are. And of course, thanks to this communication, we can organize our work related to the test planning, analysis and design, and so on. But this communication is very important because one or more reasons. Thanks to this information, we can predict some issues caused from subjective reasons. I'm sure you have found a lot of issues with subjective root causes. The most important is to communicate the mistakes with the developers in order to prevent potential issues in the future. Of course, this communication mustn't be aggressive. It must be a strong and positive communication so that the teamwork will be developed and we will be able to contribute to the delivery of a mature and, of course, of a reliable software. And to conclude, I will share with you a sentence that I like a lot. Software is knowledge made active. I think it is valid for all domains of human knowledge. So activate your knowledge and experience from your previous professions, from the university. Activate your knowledge for now. Use them in the new context of quality assurance and share them with your colleagues. It is priceless for you, for the team, for the software you're working on. Thank you. Thank you for your attention. Any questions?
Do we have any questions in Discord?
We don't have.
There is one question.
I would like to ask, how can you express a question or that you have an issue with the developer so he cannot experience like a guilt, but like the positive way? Can you give us some example?
So it depends on the personality of the developer, of course. I know the interest of each developer outside of the work. And when there is an issue, at first I make the developer communicative. And then with a smile, with some ideas, I share with him his mistake, and I hope it will be accepted in the best way.
Any other questions? Thank you, Teodora.
You can ask her for more questions or drink a beer with her outside in the coming break.
Just wait, before we all have break, I have to remind you that this is the last break when you can donate money for our cause. We will make the count during the next talk.
Also, check if there are any free slots of the, for the lightning talks. Now, time to go to drink beer. Be brave, be generous, and see you at 5 o'clock.